ban on many flavored vaping pods is now in effect, and vape shops are feeling the heat, even if they don't sell the products. New at 11 o'clock tonight, CBS4's Mike Sullivan spoke with one owner who's now making alternative products.
All right, darling, I'm going to take a quick look at your ID.
Not all products fit a one-size label.
They've taken the word vape and they've boxed us all in.
TJ Birdwell owns Vapor Vice.
It does have a charging port in it.
His store is one of countless vape shops in Indy, with some.
Another five times. There you go.
In need of a contingency plan.
The flavors are still up in arms, and that's what we're worried about.
5 days ago, a ban went into effect, halting the purchase of many flavored vaping pods. Often found at convenience stores, gas stations, or online.
They come in and grab it and they just throw it on the counter and you're lucky if you get ID'd.
You won't find them here, and for good reason.
The kids are using what, the Juul.
They can have 50 milligrams of nicotine.
Which is 50% nicotine. That is double your traditional cigarette.
So that's potent.
This is very potent.
All packed in a tiny pod.
But you see how concealable that is.
Yeah.
Just a small stick compared to the larger liquid devices Birdwell sells.
So it is waterproof, shockproof, and dustproof.
His liquids also average about 12 milligrams, a fourth of the potency.
Kids don't care about the flavors. Kids have never cared about the products that I sell. Kids care about the 50 milligram nicotine. So part of me is okay with that stuff going away.
Yet, he's still impacted.
As soon as the president spoke on it, things in our industry pretty much turned upside down.
So Birdwell turned to an alternative.
We had to have some kind of a backup plan.
His own brand of aromatherapy, bath bombs, beard oils.
All right, go ahead and put your pen in for me.
All to be sold in tandem at his shops.
There's no reason to double what's in a traditional cigarette to begin with.
And Birdwell argues, no reason to mess with him. In Indianapolis, I'm Mike Sullivan, CBS 4 News.
And those pods are often sold online, which means any teen with access to a credit card can still buy them. Birdwell warns those products can come from overseas and contain potentially harmful ingredients.
A CBS